Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hari Haraye Nama Krishna Jadavaya Namaha Jadavaya Madhavaya Keshavaya Namaha Gopala Govindaram Srimadu Sudhana Giridhari Gopinath Madana Mohana Sri Chaitanya Nityananda Sri Advaita Sita Hari Guru Vaishnava Bhagavata Gita Sri Rupa Sanatana Bhatta Raghunata Sri Jiva Gopala Bhatta Dasa Raghunata Echai Goshar Guri Charana Vandana Jaha Hoite Vignana Sabishta Puran Echai Goshai Jar Muitar Das Tasabara Padareno Mora Panchagras Atadera Charana Sebhi Bhakta Sanibas Janame Janame Hoye Abhilas Echai Goshai Jabe Brajai Koila Bhas Radha Krishna Nitya Lila Korila Prakash Anande Bolo Hari Bhaje Vrindavana Sri Guru Vaishnava Pade Majai Amana Anande bolo hari baje vrindavana Sri Guru Vaishnava pade majai amana Sri Guru Vaishnava pada padma kariyash Nama sankirtana kohe narotamadas Sri Guru Vaishnava Pada Padma Koriyash Nama Sankirtana Kohe Narottamadas Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jaya Radha, Natavara Radha, Natavara Radhe Radhe. Jaya Gauranitai, Gauranitai. Patita Pavana, Gauranitai. Jaya Jagannatha, Jagannatha, Baladeva, Jaya Subhadra, Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Srila Prabhupada, Nitai Gaur Haribol, Haribol. Hari bol, Nitai Gaura, Hari bol. Nitai Gaura, Premanande, Hari, Hari bol. Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much, Hari. Hare Krishna, dear devotees. Welcome all for the ISKCON Columbus Sunday program. And today we have a very special guest. And there is no introduction needed for this special guest today. His Holiness, His Grace Amarendra Prabhu is with us. And a short introduction, just to, as a courtesy of explaining, you know, introducing Prabhuji. Amarendra Prabhu is a disciple of His Holiness Radha Govinda Swami, Goswami Maharaj. And he holds a double master's of degree materially in US with a bigger universities, which most of the people aspire in the world outside. And Amarendra Prabhu is very known for his Bhagavatam classes and lots of seminars he gives. And he preaches through various social media platforms like YouTube, Facebook, WhatsApp, and several others. And Amarendra Prabhu is well known for knowing in the community of people in different cities around the world. He continuously travels and preaches the message of Bhagavatam. And talks about the various acharyas commentation and all the things. So we are ready. We're really fortunate, and we welcome Amarendra Prabhu. And please take over from here, Prabhu. Thank you very much for joining today.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji. Thank you. I see so many wonderful familiar faces from our Radha Natavar community. Hare Bol. Hare Krishna. It's like a very sweet virtual reunion of all of us. It's been quite a long time since we've all not, forget about meeting, we've not even left our homes. So amidst such social distancing and pandemic lockdown, I feel very, very fortunate to be here with all of you. And this morning we have a very, very sweet description and section of the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. This is called as Yugala Gita. It's one of the most beautiful, wonderful spiritual peaks, we could say, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, especially the 10th canto. So without further delaying, let us jump into this discussion. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnana Anjana Shilakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupaha Kadamahyam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guroho Shri Utapada Kamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunatanvitam Tamsajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Vitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavanishwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavinibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Preshthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharane Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschati Deshatarane Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gauravakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Hari Ram Hari Ram 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 Hari Hari. Mother Rukmini, please offer your obeisances unto me. please offer your blessings unto me. Please forgive me. I offer my obeisances unto you, and please offer your blessings unto me. please take that as a mistake of my false ego. I feel very happy to see your presence here, and at the same time, very nervous. Please forgive me if I make any mistakes. And Naveen Krishna Prabhu is also there, and my dear
Krishna, so happy to see you.
Hare Krishna. My dear friend Hari is also there, and my little friend Parikshit is also there. Mataji, to everyone, all the wonderful devotees, please accept my humble obeisances and offer your best wishes and prayers and blessings, so that I feel very protected and I feel empowered to serve all of you this morning. Our Grantra Srimad Bhagavatam. Sarva Vedanta Saramhi Shri Bhagavatam Ishyate Tadrasamrita Triptasya Na Anyatrasya Atratihi Kvachit. On the occasion of Bhadra Purnima, all over the place, all over the world, this has been the resonating factor that this Srimad Bhagavatam is Sarva Veda Antasaram. It is the essence of all transcendental knowledge. And if someone tastes even a portion, a small drop of nectar from Srimad Bhagavatam, na anyatrasyatratihi kvachit, one will not desire to taste anything else. The Srimad Bhagavatam is Radha Krishna Vangmai Swarup. It is a non-different manifestation of sound incarnation of Radha and Krishna. Sripada Indra Prabhu used to say that the white pages of the Srimad Bhagavatam represent Radharani, and the black ink, the print, represents Shama Sundar. So Radha and Krishna are doing their Ras Vilas in the pages of Granthra Srimad Bhagavatam. But very specifically, the 10th canto, this Dasham Skand, is the heart of Krishna. Some commentators have mentioned that Dasham Skand is the smiling face of Krishna, And some commentators have mentioned Dasham Skand is the heart of Krishna, because we know the first two cantos represent the lotus feet, and systematically going upwards, the 10th canto, which is the Ashraya Tattva, which is the personality manifestation who's ready to give shelter to the whole mankind. That 10th canto is none different from the smiling face or the heart of Krishna, the heartbeat of Krishna's body, that is Srimad Bhagavatam. If we take the 10th canto out, what are we all building up 9 cantos for? So, you know, on our face also, we have the eyes, the nose, the lips, the ears, and the sense of touch. 5 aspects. Similarly, you see the 10th canto, if it is the smiling face of Krishna, then there are 5 sense organs on the face, the 10th canto of Krishna's face. And they are called as the Rasa Panchadhyay, the 5 chapters of the Rasa Leela, from chapter 29 to chapter 33 of the 10th canto. Some commentators mention that this is the heart of Krishna, the 10th canto, which means in the heart, according to yoga and Ayurveda, we see we have 5 kinds of life airs. So those are the Rasa Panchadhyay. So if you take the 10th canto as the face of Krishna, then the eyes, nose, ears, lips, and the sense of touch are the 5 chapters of Rasa Leela. And if you take the 10th canto to be the heart of Krishna, then these 5 chapters are the Pancha Pran, the 5 life airs. Also, some commentators mention that there is a transcendental difference in opinion, that these 5 chapters that they mention is not just the 5 chapters of the Rasa Leela, but the 5 songs of the 10th canto. You see, Srimad Bhagavatam has many songs. You have Aila Geet, you have Rudra Geet, you have Bhumi Geet, etc. So many songs are sung. But the 10th canto is very famous for 5 types of songs, 5 different kinds of songs sung by the gopis of Vrindavan in their expression of love for Sri Krishna. And the names and the position of these 5 songs are as follows. 1, chapter 21 of canto 10 is called as the Venu Geet. Very famous, called as the Venu Geet, the song of Krishna's flute. Then chapter 31 is called as Gopi Geet. This is the most famous out of the 5 songs. We know the Gopi Geet. And because of His Holiness Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj, the whole world sang Tava Kathamritam Tapta Jivanam. This is certainly a miracle. What the gopis sang confidentially on the banks of the Yamuna on the night of Sharad Purnima under the shade of the Kadamba tree searching for Shamasundar. Srila Bhakti Charu Maharaj sang that on the microphone to the whole world. This is compassion. So the first song, which is famous, is Venu Geet of chapter 21. The second famous song is Gopi Geet, chapter 31. The third one is called as Yugala Gita, chapter 35 of the 10th canto. The fourth is called Viraha Gita, chapter 39, when Akrura takes Krishna and Balaram out. And the fifth song is called as Bhramar Gita, chapter 47. So I'm pretty sure someone would say, can you just repeat all over that again? So we'll just go a little slowly and we'll pause and we'll mention what's the commonality between the 5 songs and what's the difference between the 5 songs. Yeah. So the commonality, the similarity between the 5 songs is that these are the 5 songs sung by the gopis. And they're all for Sri Krishna's pleasure, for Gopinath. That's the similarity. Also, another similarity is that they're all in the pangs of separation. These are 5 songs all in Viraha. Viraha. Very beautiful word, Viraha. Viraha means separation. But in Sanskrit, the word vi means vishesha. And raha means rahasyamai milan. Very confidential, secretive meeting. So viraha means separation. But when you split it, it becomes vishesha rupena rahasyamai milan. Which means a very confidential, private meeting in the heart. Externally, there is separation. But internally, the gopis are meeting with Krishna in their heart. Viraha. Viraha Geet. So all the 5 songs are in the mood of viraha, separation, or vipralambha. Now, what is the subtle difference between the 5 songs? Chapter 21 is called Venu Geet. So that is in the mood of Purvarag. Very deep concepts for 1 hour of Sunday feast. But just want to make this point. Purva rag. Rag means attachment, love, anurag. And purva means initial stages. So when the first time Radha and Krishna meet, or they have the first darshan of each other, darshan for Krishna, not for Radharani. Radharani seeing Krishna. Krishna is having darshan of Radhika because she is the para tattva, the para prakriti tattva. Krishna is Krishna, but she is Bhanu Nandini. Venum karani patitam skalitam shikhandam brashtam chapita vasanam rajaraja suno yasya kataksha saraghata vimurchitasya tam radhika paricharami kadarasena. Prabodhananda Saraswati has said that Krishna was very proud of his flute. He was very proud of his peacock feather. He was very proud of his pitambar. He was very proud of his threefold bending form. And he was walking like the maddened elephant. Gati karindra ganjitam dukula pita shobhanam. He was dancing and walking like an intoxicated mad elephant. But then what happened? Oh, he saw someone. He saw a very beautiful golden maiden. And she was picking flowers, which was bedecked on the trees, the kalpa vrikshas, by Brinda Devi. And she was picking flowers and placing in the flower basket. And Krishna looked, and he looked, and he looked, and he thought, what is this? I have never seen something like this. And at that time, this golden Prishabhanu Nandini, she decided to shoot Krishna with very sharp arrows of her glance. So as she turned and she gave a sidelong glance, collapse, finished. Prabodhananda Saraswati says, that flute that Krishna was very proud of, Venum karan nipatitam, that flute fell down. Venum karan nipatitam, skalitam shikhandam. And the peacock feather also fell down. It's almost like the flute and the peacock feather were saying, oh Krishna, we were taking sides with you today, till today, because we had not seen Srimati Radhika. But today we saw Srimati Radharani. We happily change our sides. You be where you are. We are going towards our Swamini, our Sarveshwari, our Praneshwari, Makeshwari, Kriyeshwari, Swadeshwari, Sureshwari, Triveda Bharatishwari, Pramana Shashaneshwari, Rameshwari, Kshameshwari, Pramoda Kananeshwari, Vrajeshwari, Vrajadipe, Shri Radhike Namostute. Prabodhananda Saraswati says the flute fell from Krishna's hand, the peacock feather fell from Krishna's head. And Brashtancha Pita Vasanam, there was a Brashta. Brashta means to lose one's path. Brashtancha Pita Vasanam, the Pita Vasana, the yellow cloth on Krishna's body lost its path. It was always with Krishna. The Angavastra was always on Krishna's shoulder. But looking at Radharani, there was a Brashta. He fell off path. Brashtancha Pita Vasanam, Vrajaraja Suno. From whose body? Vrajaraja Suno, the son of the king of Vrindavan. And not just that. Not all of these things just falling off. Yasya Kataksha. By the sidelong glance of Radharani, Saraghata Vimurchitasya. Vishesha Murchita. Krishna fell down in such a way that he was gasping for breath. He had never seen such beauty. He had never seen such intoxicating source of devotion. Prabodhananda Saraswati says, Tam Radhika Paricharami Kadarasena. When will I have the fortune of serving the lotus feet of that Radhika? So this is Purva Rag. So the song that has been sung with the initial flowering and budding of Madhurya Rasa is called Venu Geet, first song of separation. Then there is Gopi Geet. Gopi Geet is in the part, is the middle chapter, 31 of the Rasa Panchadhyay. So when Krishna disappears from the Rasa Leela, the gopis are singing, oh, what have we done? Jayatite adhikam janmana vraja. Putana came to you, oh Krishna. And she said, leave me, leave me, leave me. But your nature is that you know only to hold and not to leave. Therefore, you held Putana without leaving her. And now when we are saying, hold us, you're ready to leave us. What is this? How is it that your nature has flipped like this? Putana came to give you poison and you gave her nectar. And we are giving nectar of our service and you're treating us as poison. This is Gopi Geet. And then the third song is what is the topic for today's discussion. I'm still busy introducing it. I don't know when I'm going to start it. But anyway, we'll come to that. We'll skip the introduction for the third. Fourth is Viraha Geet. That is separation of the gopis from Sri Krishna when Akrura snatches Krishna out. So this is an explosion of losing Krishna. The gopis are singing, Aho vidhata tavana kvachiddaya. Oh vidhata, oh Brahmaji. So till today, the gopis had only criticized Brahmaji for being a foolish creator. But today they criticize Brahmaji for being a foolish planner also. It is almost like Brahmaji in Brahmalok every day in his news article, in his newspaper would see the headline says, gopis criticize you today, you know. Why the gopis would criticize Brahmaji? Because the interesting creation of Brahmaji is such that Indra, who's busy looking at Ramba, Urvashi and Menaka, is called Sahasraksha. He's given 1,000 eyes. And Brahmaji has 4 heads with 2 eyes each. So he has 8 eyes. And he has those eyes, but he's busy closing them and meditating and finding nothing. So Indra looks at the Apsaras and he's been given 1,000 eyes. And Brahma, for closing his eyes, he's been given 8 eyes. He's given himself 8 eyes. And humans are given 2 eyes. And that to Brajbasis, in whose land Krishna's appeared, they also have 2 eyes. Humans outside have 2 eyes. Inside, also 2 eyes. What's the difference between a Brajbasi and Lokabasi? And that too, those 2 eyes are created in such a way that the eyelids are always dropping over the eyeballs and stopping the vision of Sri Krishna. When Krishna is not in Vrindavan, they have the audacity to open. The eyelids open. And when Krishna is in Vrindavan, they have the audacity to drop. And even when the eyelids are open and Krishna is in Vrindavan, they Vishuddha Sattvic Vikar, tremble, the body trembles with Vishuddha Sattvic Vikar, that eyes are filled, moist with tears and streams of separation, prema vaichitya, bhavi viraha, spread all through the cheek. And now those tears come between the eyes and Sri Krishna. What kind of creation is this? Oh, Brahmaji, what kind of faulty creation is this? You should give outside everyone only 1 eye, because anyway, they're not looking at Krishna. And Brahma, you should not give yourself any eyes because you're anyway meditating. But for Brajvasis, you should give eye in every pore of their body. And you can give eyelids, no problem. But for Brajagopis, you should give eyes in every pore of the body without the eyelids. This is proper creation. But today your creation has failed and even your planning has failed. He whose name is Akrura, Krura means cruelty and A means no. He whose name is Akrura, not cruel, becomes Krurtam Murtiman. He's coming as the personification of cruelty. Namadhayana kim phalam? What is the use of this name then? Namah tu dhanapali tathapi sa nirdhana. Imagine if somebody's name is Dhanapali. Dhana means wealth and Pali means protection. Somebody's name is Dhanapali. Namah tu dhanapali tathapi sa nirdhana. Her name could be the great protector of wealth, but if her bank balance is zero, what's the use of such a name? So similarly, he is Krurta Swarup. He is the manifestation of cruelty. And the name you have given him is Akrura. You're torturing us and you're taking Krishna away. Aho vidhata tava na kvachiddaya. You have no mercy on us. This is Viraha Geet, chapter 39. And then chapter 47 is called Bhramar Geet. Bhramar Geet. Bhramar means black bumblebee. So when Uddhava comes as a messenger, Vrushni naam pravaro mantri, Krishnasya daita sakha, shishyo brihaspate sakshat, Uddhavo buddhi sattama. When that Uddhava comes to Vrindavan as a messenger of Krishna at the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani, at that time, there's a black bumblebee which is doing parikrama of the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani. And Srimati Radharani chastises the bumblebee. And that is called Bhramar Geet. So Bhramar means black bumblebee and Geet means song. So our acharyas have given many perspectives. They say that Radharani is in such divya unmad, madanakhya mahabhav, such high class love that she does not know whom to speak and whom not to speak. And she's expressing her heart to a bumblebee. That in itself is a proof of her very exalted nature. Point number one. Point number two, some acharyas say that Radharani actually wanted to talk to Uddhav. But because it is not culture to look into the eyes of another man and speak, Radharani is looking down at the bumblebee and giving the message to Uddhav. Uddhav is a messenger, but Radharani is making the bumblebee a messenger between Radharani and the messenger of Krishna. I have nothing to do with the messenger of Krishna. I need a messenger between the messenger of Krishna and me. That's the state of love. Third, acharyas say, it was Shamsundar himself who came as a black bumblebee to touch the lotus of Radharani's feet to apologize. Please forgive me, I left your association. And then Radharani is chastising Shamsundar, who has appeared as a Brahmara. So in this way, this is called Brahmar Geet or Uddhav Sandesh, that section. So these are the four songs we have described. Then, so that is also in separation after Krishna has left Vrindavan. So what is this Yugal Geet? Yugal Geet is also in separation, but this is when the gopis are at home and Krishna is into the forest during daytime. Krishna is in Vrindavan. This is chapter 35. So Krishna has not left Vrindavan. He is in Vrindavan, but the gopis are in the village and Krishna is in the forest. Krishna is in the forest. And all day long, Krishna is in the forest with his cows and calves. And Krishna is with gopas playing vana vihar, vana bhojan, playing on his flute. And the gopis here in the forest, in the village of Vrindavan, they're burning in separation. That alas, alas, we wish we were in male forms. We could have gone with Krishna as a gopa. But unfortunately, we are in female forms that we have to be here in the village instead of go to the forest. So this mood of separation that the gopis expressed when Krishna went to the forest, leaving the village during the daytime while being in Vrindavan, this is called Yugal Geet. Is everyone clear? You give me a nod of your head. Am I going too fast or is it okay? Is it making sense?
Yeah, good, Prabhu. Thank you.
Okay, good. So, but why is it called Yugal? You see, Venu Geet, we understand. Gopi Geet, we understand. Viraha Geet, we understand. Brahmar Geet, we understand. But why is this called Yugal Geet? Oh, Yugal means two. Yugala Kishore. Radha Krishna Pranamor. Jugala Kishore. Jugal. Two. So why is this what is the pair about? This chapter of Yugal Geet runs in pairs. There are 12 pairs of two verses each. So 26 verses total in this chapter. First verse is an introduction. The last verse is like a conclusion. But in the middle, there are 24 verses of the Yugal Geet. And they run in 12 pairs. Is this clear? So 12 times 2 is 24. And it's interesting. The gopis change the subject matter every two verses. So for a certain aspect, they give two verses. And then after two verses, they change the subject matter and another two verses. Then again, they change subject matter, another two verses. They again change subject matter, another two verses. So that which moves in pairs like this is called the Yugal Geet. It's a transcendental pair of movement. And it's interesting. Those two verses also given to a certain subject. The first verse talks about the cause or the description. And the second verse talks about the effect. What is the first verse leading to? That's the connection. So of course, if we had more time, let's say 10 days or something, we could have spent time going through these different verses and the mood. But to keep time to what we have selected a certain section of the Yugal Geet. We can finish all the 12 pairs of 24 verses, but we have selected to start with verse 6 and 7. I've randomly picked this section of the Yugal Geet. And then it's very, very interesting. Very, very interesting. Text 6 and 7. So I would request the devotees, you can, wherever you are, you can pull it up online or, you know, if you put it in the chat, devotees have, those who are not aware, yeah, they have an access to the Veda-based link. Or if you have the Srimad Bhagavatam with you in person, Shubhasya Shigram. So let's start. Very nice set of two verses. And because it's a Geet, it is to be sung. There are a couple of ways that I am aware of singing this. I'm pretty sure there are many other ways also, but I am unaware of those melodies. But there are two melodies which we can sing this Yugal Geet in. Again, by the way, it's interesting that since it's Yugal, we have two ways to sing this set of verses. So the first one, and we can pick the way that is comfortable for us to sing. So the first one, we can sing it as Barhinastavakadhatupalashaye Baddhamalla paribarha vidamba Karhi chitsavala alisa gopai Gasamavayati yatra mukunda. So we can sing it like this. So this is very, very famous. This we may have heard. For those who had a chance to hear the famous Ramayan series, which was telecasted many, many years ago, you may have heard the famous way of singing different verses of Goswami Tulsidas' compositions. They would sing those verses of the Ramayana like that. Sita Ram Charita Ti Pavan Madhura Sarasa Arumanati Bhavan. So we can sing it like that. Or another way, we can sing it in the melody of Vrindavana Ramyasthana in Rupaktal. So I'll try to sing it like that.
Barhinastavaka dhatupalashaye Baddhamalla paribarha vidamba Karhichitsabala alisa gopai Gasamavayati yatra mukunda tarhi bhagna gataya sarito vai tat padambo jarajo nila nitam sprihayati vayam Iva bahu punya prema vepita bhuja simitapa.
So in this way, we can sing it like Vrindavana Ramyasthana. So whenever we have time now, especially with the start of Purushottam Adhik Mas, there are many devotees I know, they sing the Gopi Geet, they sing the Yugala Gita. So you can do that for your Purushottam Adhik Vrat. Or you can even pick selected verses from different songs and stutis of the Bhagavatam. And you can club your daily Dainik Prarthana. So let us start with our discussion of these two verses. It's very, very beautiful. Please give your complete attention to this discussion for the next half an hour or so. I'm pretty confident that you will walk out of the discussion at the end with a smile, offering gratitude to Shukadev Goswami and the Braja Gopis for giving us such nectar through these verses. So first, let us get to the translation. I'll just quickly read the translation. Let me quickly pull it up, just a minute. Yeah. My dear Gopi, sometimes Mukunda imitates the appearance of a wrestler by decorating himself with leaves, peacock feathers, and colored minerals. Then in the company of Balaram and the cowherd boys, he plays his flute to call the cows. At that time, the rivers stop flowing, their water stunned by the ecstasy they feel as they eagerly wait for the wind to bring them the dust of his lotus feet. But like us, now the gopis are talking, but like us, the rivers are not very pious, and thus they merely wait with their arms trembling out of love. So this is the translation. We'll also go through the word by word meaning. So if you're writing down, this is a good point to start the discussion, the penning down the words. So you see in the sixth verse, the word Ali has been used. Karihichit sa bala Ali sa gopaihi. Gaha sama vayati yatra mukundaha. So the word Ali refers to Gopi. Sakhi. O friend. O Priya Sakhi. We know in the Guru Vashtakam we sing Nikunjayuno rati keli siddhyai yaya alibhi yuktirapekshaniya. That the spiritual master is tatra ati daksha. He's very expert. What is he expert in? Yaya, whatever alibhi yuktihi. Whatever the alibihi, the gopis make plans in the meeting of Radha and Krishna, Nikunja Yuno, Ratikeli Siddhyai, for the meeting of Radha and Krishna in the very beautiful pleasure groves of Vrindavan. Whatever planning the gopis make to execute those plans, Yaya alibihi, whatever the gopis plan, Tatra Ati Daksha, the guru in her Sakhi Swarup, in her Manjari Swarup, is very expert in executing those plans. And therefore, Ati Vallabha. She is very dear to Radha and Krishna. Tvam Gopika Vrisharavestana Yanti Kesi Seva Dhikarine Guru Nijapada Padme Dasyam Pradaya Kurumam Vrajakana Neshri Radhangri Seva Narase Sukhinim Sukhabdo. Therefore, we pray to the spiritual master both in the Gaura Leela Swarup and Krishna Leela Swarup as Manjari. So, Ali means Sakhi or Gopi. So, it is basically an invocation. It's a sambodhan. So the gopis are talking to each other. Hey, Ali. Now, after the sakhi is looking, said, yes, what is your bhav? What are you expressing? So then the first two lines have been mentioned. Barhina, stabaka, dhatu, palashaihi. The gopi starts describing the form of Krishna, the form of Shamasundar, vishesha, roop of Shamasundar. So what are the different mentions, different words mentioned? The first word mentioned is barhina. We know the word barha means peacock feather. Actually, the word barha means peacock. But just like when you have to, there are so many words that we use in English where the actual meaning would be something, but the colloquial usage of the same word is something different. So instead of using the word barha for peacock, the casual usage in Shastra of the word barha is a peacock feather. Or when so many peacock feathers have been used that it's as good as stacking up peacock feathers in the shape of a peacock, then it's also called barha. So Krishna is barha pidam. So barha means peacock feather. Mayura pichhani, the commentators describe. Plural usage of mayura pichha, peacock feathers. So Krishna is made out of peacock feathers. That's the fundamental shringar of Krishna. Even an abstract painting, you don't show any Rupa Madhuri of Krishna, but just draw a flute and make a peacock feather. You ask anyone, they will say, oh, this is Krishna, right? You don't have to make Vrindavan. You don't have to make Mother Yashoda, Radharani, Gopis, Gopas, even a cow. No Giriraj, no Yamuna. Just make a peacock feather and everyone relates the peacock feather to Krishna. So the peacock feather is the mukhya shringar vastu, the main ingredient of shringar for Krishna. So barhina, the gopis are describing to each other. Krishna is he's decorated himself with not just one peacock feather, but mayura pichhani, plural usage of many, many peacock feathers. And of course, there are many reasons why Krishna holds a peacock feather. If we get into that, we will not be able to do justice to our topic. So in the interest of time, we'll continue. So barhina, Krishna's wearing a peacock feather. What else is he beholding as a shringar? Stabaka. Stavaka means pushpa guccha. Pushpa means flowers and guccha means like a bouquet, almost like a group of flowers. So Krishna has flower shringar all over his body. He has flower bangles or bracelets, so to speak. He has a flower necklace, flower earrings. Krishna has flower waist bells and flower ankle bells, almost like bells because the flowers are moving back and forth as Krishna's walking and wrestling and jumping. So he's completely decorated in vanyavesh. He's decorated as if ready to go into the forest. So mayur picha, barhina, stabaka, flowers. Then another decoration for Krishna is dhatu. Dhatu means natural minerals. The friends don't use any, you know, cosmetic. They don't use any paints on Krishna. They use everything natural, organic. So they take different leaves and different fruits and they crush them together and make different colors and different powders and different pastes. And they do face painting and cheek painting for Krishna. They make nice gopa dots and nice decorations on Krishna's forehead and on Krishna's cheeks. Even Radharani has many nice decorations on her face. Lalita Sakhi, it's described by Rupa Goswami. When Lalita Sakhi would make different kinds of designs on Radharani's forehead, Lalita Sakhi as Anuradha walks behind Radharani, but she is a Jeshta Sakhi, 27 days older in Goloka Vrindavan. So when she's making these decorations on Radharani's forehead, she blesses Radharani that the perfection of these decorations is when by the sweat drops of your ecstasy, they melt down your lotus feet and they fall drop by drop on the head of Sri Krishna, who has placed his lotus head at your lotus feet. So in this way, Lalita Sakhi blesses Radharani that may these face paintings come to the fullest quality of the intention behind their decorations. May they reach their goal of falling on the head of Krishna through dripping drops of honey from your lotus feet. So in this way, the gopas also decorate Krishna. And they sometimes fight also. No, I will do it. I will do it. Aham purvam, aham purvam. I'm going to be the first one. I'm going to be the first one. So in this way, they have decorations. And also Krishna's cheeks are like reflective mirrors. The gopas are doing shringar, looking at the cheeks of Krishna. Very reflective. Ganda mandala. In Radharaman temple, they sing, Jai Prana Dhana Radharaman Shri Gopala Bhata Juke Ladle Jaya Mor Mukuta Jukoe Bae Peet Ambar Rajhi Jai Makar Kundala Shravana Jhume Ganda Mandal Bhrajhi Jai Prana Dhana Radharaman Shri Gopala Bhat Juke Ladle. They say, we bow down to Radharaman, the Prananath of Gopal Bhatta Goswami. And how is he? Jai Mor Mukuta. He has Mor Mukut. Jhukoe Bae. But it is not bending to the right. It's bending to the left. The Mor Mukut is bending to the left. Jhukoe Bae. Why? Because Radharani is there. The peacock feather wants to fall at Radharani's feet. And Peet Ambar Rajari. And then Krishna has nice Peet Ambar. Yet at the same time, Jaya Makara Kundala Shravana Jhume. He has earrings in the fame of in the shape of sharks and moving back and forth. And Ganda Mandala Vrajahi. And he has nice chubby cheeks, which are very reflective. Goraj se bhare hai kapol. Jai Jai Radha Raman Hari Bol. His face is filled with goraj, the dust from the hoofs of the cows. So these cheeks are decorated with dhatu, with natural minerals. When we go to Vrindavan, we see in Khadiravan, there's one of the forests of the 12 forests of Braj, Dwadashakanan, Brajmandal. Khadiravan is very special. Our Lokanath Goswami, the spiritual master of Narottam Das Thakur, did bhajan there. And he worshipped Radha Vinod Bihari there. So why is Khadiravan coming in this context? Because the forest gets its name because of Khadir. Khadir is a small bear-like fruit. And when you crush them, you get red color. So that red color is used by the gopis there to apply alta or lac at the feet of Srimati Radharani. Redness of Radharani's lotus feet comes from the Khadir fruits. So that forest is called Khadiravan. So I was mentioning this in the context that the gopas and the gopis for Radha and Krishna, they do natural decorations with minerals. So barha means mayur picha, that is peacock feather. Stabaka refers to pushpa guccha or flowers. And dhatu refers to natural minerals. And palasha, you know the word palasha. Yad pada pankaja palasha vilasa bhaktya. The fourth canto, Bhagavatam, has this verse, palasha. Palash means fresh budding leaves on the tree. So Krishna is his shringar. The gopis are remembering and talking to each other that Krishna's shringar is having these four things: peacock feather, flowers, leaves, and natural dhatu, that is minerals, nice face painting. This is the shringar. But how do the gopis know about it? How do the gopis know that these are the decorations that are there on Krishna's body? So either they may have seen Krishna leave from the village to the forest. So while going, while Krishna's leaving, they would have had darshan of Krishna. And that impression of Krishna's leaving the village to the forest is what they're describing. Or they may have heard from other gopas that this is what Krishna has worn today. Because it's possible that the gopis, because they are parakya bhavmai gopis, they have their household duties and their husbands and mother-in-law and whatnot. So they're stuck at home. So they may not have got the chance to see Krishna leave, but they may have heard from some gopas who may have come, Spriya Narama Sakhas, to Krishna and Radharani, to come and say, you didn't see Shyamasundar, but I'll describe how he looks today. Or it's possible by their bhavanetra. The gopis were in the village, but their hearts went with Krishna. So in their bhav, in their consciousness, Krishna is giving them darshan. And that's how they are revealing these things. So now, barha, stabaka, dhatu, palasha. How is all of this put together? Baddha. It's tied up together. Baddha, we know. Bandhan or baddha. We say nitya baddha jivas. Those jivas who are eternally bound up in this world, etc. In the baddha avastha. We use these words often. Baddha avastha means in a conditioned state in this world. So baddha means to be tied up. So it's almost like Krishna has like a head cloth. It's like a head cloth, like a feta or a pagdi. Actually, in Vrindavan, Krishna does not wear mukut. Mukut Krishna wears in Mathura and in Dwarka. But in Braj, he is Leela Vihari. He is Vana Vihari. So he has natural cloth in which he has peacock feathers and nice, beautiful flowers and face painting and a lot of fresh leaves and sometimes even fruits. They place different fruits around Krishna's body. This is Krishna Shringar. So Baddha, it's all tied up together. But how is Krishna looking? Malla. Baddha Malla. Malla means like a wrestler. We know in the pastime of Krishna going to Mathura, there is a very beautiful verse. Mallanam ashanindranam naravara strinam smaro murtiman gopanam swajano satam kshitibujam shasta swapitra shisho mrityu bhojapater virat avidusham tattvam param yoginam vrushninam paradevateti vidito rangam gata chagrajah. Shukadev Goswami says, when Malla Yuddha, when Krishna went to fight, then different aspects of the audience, they glanced at Krishna with different bhavs. Mallanam Ashani, the wrestler saw Krishna like thunderbolt. Mallanam Ashani Nrunam, the men saw Krishna as Naravara, best among men. And Strinam, the women saw Krishna as Smara Murtiman, as Sakshat Cupid walking. And Gopanam Swajano, the gopas saw Krishna as Swajana, my own person is coming. Gopanam Swajano, Asatam Kshiti Bhujam, the impious kings, they saw Krishna as Shasta, which means Shasan Karnevala, discipliner, chastiser. Swapitra Shishu, Krishna's parents saw Krishna as Shishu, own child. Mrityu, Bhojapate Virat Avidusham. How did Kamsa Maharaj see Krishna? Kamsa Maharaj saw Krishna as Mrityu. Bhojapate saw Krishna as Mrityu. Mrityu Bhojapate Virat Avidusham. The foolish Avidusham, the less intelligent, saw Krishna as Virat, which means the formless has taken a form. And Tattvam Param Yoginam. The yogi saw Krishna as the highest truth walking. Vrushninam, the Vrushni saw Krishna as Paradevata, as their worshipable deity. Vrushninam Paradevateti Vidito, understanding in this way, Rangam Gataha Cha Agrajaha. Krishna entered that wrestling arena with his Agraja Balaram. So I mentioned this because the word Mallanam has been used there. So Malla means Malla Yuddha Kari, which means a wrestler. So Krishna is compared to by the gopis here as a wrestler. Krishna looks like a wrestler. So two meanings here, primary meaning. You see, you can't wear a dhoti and you can't wrestle. So you tie it up or you tie it behind. You tie it in an interesting way that it doesn't, obstruct the wrestling. So Krishna has tied his dhoti like that. Or another meaning could be, he is so strong He's so strong that he pins his friends down. Although he looks so beautiful and delicate with his decorations, he pins his friends down like the best among wrestlers. And it's almost like he's making fun. He's making a mockery of the big wrestlers. You see, in Vrindavan, there are so many beautiful stories where Krishna pins his friends down, but most of the time he gets pinned by his friends down. One time, Sridhama, one of Krishna's four Priya Narma Sakhas, closest, Sridham, Sudham, Vasudham, King Keni. Rupa Goswami describes they are like the expansion of Krishna's mind, body, intelligence, and true ego. So Sridhama once challenged Krishna that I am stronger than you. Krishna said, okay, let's see. So Sridhama said, anyone who puts the other one down and pins him, he wins. Krishna said, agreed. So then Sridhama in no time pins Krishna down on a count of 1, 2, and 3. And Sridhama wins. Krishna says, no, I have won it. Because the contest was, anyone whose nose is facing the sky is the winner. Krishna tells Sridhama, when you pinned me down, your nose is facing the ground. But my nose is facing the sky. Therefore, I am the winner. So in this way, many sweet pastimes in the soft mud of Raj has taken place. So therefore, remembering these pastimes, the gopis say that Malla, Krishna, either his dressing or his activities are like a wrestler. So now, what are the next, what is the next word that they say? They say, Paribarha Vidamba. Paribarha is clothing and Vidamba is imitating, to act like. So either his clothing is like a wrestler or his acting, his activities are like that of a wrestler. Who else is there along with Krishna in the meditation of the gopis? Sa Bala. Balaramena Saha, which means Balaram is also there next to Krishna. And Sa Gopaihi, Gopaihi Saha, which means he's also surrounded by the gopi, the gopas, the cowherd boys. And also Gaha. Gaha means the cows. And what is Krishna doing? Samavayati. Sam means samyak rupena, completely. And ahvayati means to call. Krishna calls. Ahvahan karna. In Hindi they say ahvahan. Bulana. To call out to someone. Also literally in Braj Bhasha, when you say ahvahan, it means for a cow, you call the cow. You make these sounds. You know, different animals have different sounds that you make to get them closer. So for a cow, Krishna, like a cowherd boy, he's calling out to them. And he's doing it very nicely. Samyag rupena. So samavayati. Krishna is with all of this attire, with his friends, with Balaram, like a wrestler, fighting and dressed like a wrestler, with the cows. He's calling out to them very wonderfully. And yatra, at that time, wherever he does this, who? Mukundaha. The gopis are not calling Krishna as Krishna or Keshava or Madhava. They call him as Mukunda. Now, dear devotees, the word Mukunda has many sweet meanings. Muktim pradata sarvesham vishnurevana samshayam. One primary meaning of the word Mukunda is Mukti pradata, the giver of liberation. But that is outside Braj. In Braja, Krishna is not the giver of liberation. How many of us think Krishna is the giver of liberation in Braja? He's not the giver of liberation in Braja. Because if he was the giver of liberation in Braja, why is it that he couldn't liberate himself when Mother Yashoda bound him up? What to speak of giving liberation to others? He can't even gift himself liberation. Krishna is he who binds everyone in Braja. But outside Vrindavan, he may be Mukti Pradata. So what is the meaning of Mukunda here? Mu means Mukham, face. Or very specifically, Mukham means mouth. And Kunda. Kunda means a Kunda flower. In Vrindavan, there is a Kunda flower. But when it starts to grow, it's like small white buds. So Mukhe, in whose mouth the teeth are so beautiful, as if rows of buds of white Kunda flower have been placed, is Mukunda. So beautiful, isn't it? Mu means Mukhe, in the mouth. And Kunda means nice small white buds. So he whose the row of teeth, instead of saying Krishna's teeth are like rows of pearls, well, yes, that's an Aishwaryaman description, Aishwaryamai description. But this is Mukhe Kunda. White, soft Kunda flower-like buds are arranged in whose mouth? and they are the teeth. That is Mukunda. So very specifically, here the gopis are remembering the smiling face of Krishna. Sometimes when Krishna smiles, some of the teeth are seen. So they may have seen that in their Bhavi Netra, the smile of Krishna, the teeth of Krishna, and therefore they call him Mukunda. Also, Sripad Vallabhacharya in his Subodhani Tika, he mentions Mukunda. He gives a very beautiful meaning to the word Mukunda. He says, Mu means Mukti. Very beautiful. Mu means Mukti. And Ku means Kupsita. Kupsita means Jugupsita, disgust. Mu means Mukti. Ku means Kupsita, disgust. And Mukun. To means Ananda, happiness. And the Dadati, to bestow. He who gives so much happiness to a Vrajvasi, that if someone comes and asks in Vrindavan, can I get liberation? The Vrajvasi's face will be disgusted. You are coming to a sweet shop and asking for a shoe? Imagine you come to a sweet shop, a rasgulla, gulab jamun, jalebi shop, and you come and ask, can I get a bata Hawaii chappal? Can I get a chappal? The person will say, oh, mister, you're asking for a shoe in a sweet shop. So Vrindavan is a sweet shop where you get the sweet of Braja Prem. And there, please don't come and ask the shoe of Mukti. So Mu means Mukti. Ku means Kupsita, disgust. N means Ananda. And Da means Dadati. He who gives so much happiness that even the thought of liberation, going to Krishna for our liberation from suffering, that is Jugupsita. It is disgusting thought. Like that. But the gopis are saying this in grief, that he who gives so much happiness that mukti seems disgusting, he is not even able to give us mukti from our family and give the ananda of his association. What is the use of calling him Mukunda? We are saying he gives so much happiness that we don't desire mukti. But at this point, the gopis are saying, we desire mukti from our family bonds so that we can come and have the ananda of Krishna's association. Isn't this a paradox, dear devotees? The gopis are crying in their heart that this is that Mukunda who gives so much pleasure that we don't desire liberation. But to that Krishna, we come and we beg for liberation from our family so that we can get the ananda of his association. So much bhav, dear devotees. You see, Srimad Bhagavatam prati shloke prati akshare nana arthe kaye Krishna tulya Bhagavat vibhu sarvashray. The Srimad Bhagavatam granthraj. It's not just granthraj for namesake. Every word has so much meaning. And if you think it was beautiful till now, please welcome into the room of beauty. The next verse just opens up the whole context. After describing Krishna in this verse, the gopis step ahead to verse 7. And they sing, Tarhi bhagna gatayo sarito vai tat padambuja rajo nilanitam sprihayatir vayam ivabahu punya prema vepita bhuja smita stimitapah. So the gopis are saying, Yarhi, when Krishna, who's dressed like this, like a wrestler with Balaram and his friends, calls out to the cows, at that time, what happens? Tarhi. The seventh verse is in connection to that. So the context here is, when Krishna takes the cows to the forest, the first thing that he does, he takes the cows to drink water so that the cows can drink water and quench their thirst. Early in the morning, Krishna does that because poor cows, because of overnight fasting, they may not have drunk water. So first thing Krishna does early in the morning, takes the cows either to Manasi Ganga or to Jamuna. He takes them. And of course, our Braj Mandal has so many water bodies. But primarily, because the context here is that of a Sarita, which means a river, flowing river. So it could be Yamuna, most probably. So Krishna is taking the cows on the banks of the Yamuna or Manasi Ganga or any river. And then the cows are drinking water. And as they're drinking water, Krishna does Ga Samavayati. He calls out to the cows. Cholo, cholo, now you have to go to grace. Don't drink so much water that you have no time to drink, no time to eat the grass. Recently, in a couple of discussions, we were mentioning one verse, very, very beautiful. It shows Krishna's love for cows in Vrindavan. And the verse says, Bhruṣe goshata hankrite stutishatai maunam vidatse satam. Krishna, you have so much love for the cows in Braj. that Maunam Vidatse Satam. When yogis remember you and try to talk to you in their meditation, you as Paramatma keep quiet. But one cow in Vrindavan once says, enough. Krishna will sit there. Bruṣe, you start talking, Krishna. Bruṣe, go shata hunkrite. The cow does hum once. Hunkrite. Interesting word. Hunkrite. Kriti means activity. So the cow does hum. So the poet writes, Bruṣe, go shata hunkrite. So once you do hum, the cow does hum. And Krishna sits there and speaks to the cow 100 times. What happened? Are you hungry? Are you thirsty? Are you feeling heat of the sun? Do you want to bathe? Do you want me to release the rope? Is it too tight on you? Or do you want to sit down? Do you want to play with me? Are you missing your calf? One who? Oh, Krishna, what is going on? Bruṣe go shata hum krite stuti shataihi maunam vidatse satam. Yogis are busy stuti shataihi, hundreds and hundreds of poetries in their dhyana avastha, but as Paramatma, maunam vidatse satam, you keep quiet. But one cow in Vrindavan does hum once, and you sit there. You give up all your activities, you suspend, and you sit there. In fact, your name is Gopal and Govind. You sit there, taking care of the cow. So much love you have for the cows. Therefore, Krishna, nyatam Krishna tavangri pankaja yugam premaiva labhyam param. We are convinced. If we have to approach you, we have to approach you like the cow, not like the yogi. We have to approach you with love. Vidhi bhakti, braja bhav, paite nahi shakti. Shakala jagate more kare vidhi bhakti. Vidhi bhakti, braja bhav, paite nahi shakti. Aishwarya jnanete shavaga jagata mishrit. Aishwarya shitila prem nahi mora prit. Chira kale nahi diye prema bhakti dan. Prema bhakti bina nahi jagate ravasthan. Apani karimu bhakt bhave angikare. Apani karimu bhakti shikhamu shabare. Prema rasa niryas korite aswadan. Ragamarg bhakti loke korite pracharan. In the fourth chapter of Adhirila Chaitanya Charitamrita, Kaviraj Goswami gives the expression of Krishna's heart. Krishna is thinking that the whole world is praying to me, but I don't want this. You keep your prarthana with yourself. Don't give me your prarthana. Give me your heart. Don't give me your money. You can give your money if it is backed with the heart. But without the heart, the money is not going to satisfy me. Manye dhana vijana rupa tapa shrutauja steja prabhava bala paurusha buddhi yoga na aradhanaya hi bhavanti parasya pumsam bhaktya tutosha bhagavan gajayutapaya. Prahlad stuti, canto 7, chapter 9, text 9, Bhagavatam. That just with wealth, Krishna is not obtained. This world wants our wealth. Krishna wants our heart. We are busy giving our heart to this world and wealth to Krishna. Better to give our wealth to this world and heart to Krishna. That is what Krishna wants. So here, as Krishna is feeding the Yamuna water to the cows, the cows are busy drinking the Yamuna water. Then the gopis are saying, now look at the twist in the story here. The gopis are saying, oh dear Sakhi, do you see that? Look at the situation of the river. Tarhi, at that time, bhagna gatayaha. Bhagna means broken and gati means flow. Look, the Sarita, the river, why indeed her flow gets broken when Krishna calls the cows. And at the same time, tat pada, tat means Krishna, tasya, pada means lotus feet, and pada means feet, ambuja means lotus. So tat padambuja, his lotus feet, raja means dust, and anila means pavanena. Anitam. Anila means breeze, pavana. And anitam or neetam means to bring. Oh, Sakhi, did you see or do you see in your bhavi netra, bhava netra, that when Krishna calls the cows, finished drinking, cholo, cholo, now we have to graze also, we have to eat also, come, come. When he does that, did you see that the breeze is blowing and it is carrying some of the dust of Krishna's lotus feet close to the bank of the river. And the river at that time, desiring to get a small speck of the dust from Krishna's lotus feet, bhagna gati, the flow of the river gets broken. And what happens? Sprihayati, the river desires to get that dust of the feet of the Supreme Lord, which has been got by Pavana. It has been got by the wind. Krishna is far away, dear devotees. When Krishna is coming very close to the banks of the river, at that time, the river sometimes can splash and touch the feet of Krishna and go back and tell other droplets of water in the river that, oh, we got some dust from Krishna's lotus feet. And sometimes Krishna may sit on a tree branch, which is just above the river. So Krishna may sit on that tree branch and put his legs down and move his legs. So what happens? Sometimes in the flow of the water, the river may just jump a little and take some dust from Krishna's lotus feet. But that is only sometimes when Krishna comes close to the river. But most of the times when Krishna is far away and the cows are drinking water, Krishna from a distance calls the cows. So what happens at that time? The river, he joins hands with Pavandev, with Vayudev, with the wind god. In fact, Prabodhananda Saraswati says, Dhanyati dhanya pavanena kritarthamani. Yogindra Durgama Gate Madhusudanopi Tasya Namostu Vrishabhanu Bhuvodishepi. That just like the devotee's desire, the dust from the lotus feet of Krishna, Krishna desires just the breeze coming from Barsana. Prabodhananda Saraswati says, when Krishna, his garment, the tip of his garment cloth is touched by the breeze coming from Barsana Dham, Dhanyati Dhanya Pavanena Kritarthamani, Krishna considers himself to be very, very blessed. So here what is happening, dear devotees? The river is desiring to get the dust from Krishna's feet, but the river cannot jump and get it. So has a hand-in-hand collaboration with the breeze. And the breeze carries the dust from Krishna's lotus feet and brings very close to the banks. Not directly, little close to the banks of the river. And at that time, what happens? The river in excitement, bhagna gatayaha. Its flow is broken. Sarita is river. The flow is broken and sprihayati, it desires, spriha, desire ajata hai. There is a desire that develops in the heart of the river that I also want it. But however, to get that, the river has to jump out and get that that dust from the feet of Krishna. But what to do? Prema vepitaha bhujaha. Here the word bhuja means waves. The waves of the river are prema vepita. They are trembling in happiness. But at the same time, there is distress that they are so close to the dust from Krishna's feet. That is, well, the happiness is Krishna's dust has come so close. And the vepita, the trembling nature of distress is that we are still not able to procure. We are still not able to get it. Why? Because the river are held on both sides by the two banks. The banks are not letting the river jump out because that brings in the boundary, right, for the flow. So the banks of the river don't let the river cross over. Therefore, the river is trembling in happiness that it is so close, but in distress that, you know, two banks, please let me go. Let me take the dust from the feet of Sri Krishna. And when when they are stopped by the banks, vepita also means they are trying to, the river is trying to puja, trying to move its waves by saying, let me go, please let me go, don't stop me. Let me get the dust from Krishna's feet. And when they're not allowed, stimita. Stimita means they are stunned and they are not moving. As if in the state of shock. Either in the state of happiness when they get it, samadhi. When they don't get it, it's almost like breakdown. They go completely pale, go completely white. They lose their identity. They are stambhita. They are completely stunned. So why are the gopis saying this? Why are the gopis saying this? They say, Vayam Iva. The story of this river, oh dear Sakhi, is like our life. The story of this river is like our life. Why? First of all, dear devotees, look at this. Why are the gopis connecting the cow grazing pastime to the river? Because when Krishna calls the cows have feminine names. And many of those names of the cows match with the name of the rivers. So when Krishna is calling the name of the cow, feminine name, the river thinks actually Krishna is coming so close to me and calling me and tries to jump out. Bhagna gati. And Krishna has come so close to me. Please accept me. So gopis are using the river example with the cow to show their state. that just like many of the feminine names of the cows are matching with the feminine names of the river, and the river feels that Krishna is calling me when Krishna is calling the cow. Oh, Sakhi, our life is also like that. We are also feminine like the rivers, and many of the names of the cows match with our names. And when Krishna calls out the cows, we get bhagna gati. We get disoriented. It's almost like Krishna is calling me. But however, it's interesting. The river is supposed to flow towards the river's husband, that is the ocean. But when Krishna calls the name of the cow, bhagna gati, the river forgets to flow towards her husband, the ocean, and desires to flow towards Krishna. Oh, Sakhi, this is our life. We are supposed to flow towards our husband, like the river is supposed to flow towards the ocean. But when Krishna calls out to the cow, whose name, many of those names are the names of the rivers. Similarly, when Krishna calls out to the cows and many of those feminine names are our names, we, although are supposed to flow towards the service of our husbands, bhagnagati, we get disoriented and we desire to flow towards Krishna. Second point, the river, the situation of the river is such that it is stopped on two sides, two banks, and it is not able to move. Two banks, not able to move. The gopis say that is our life. The two banks that are stopping our flow are the father's side and the father-in-law's side. The two banks of the river of our life are the father's family and the father-in-law's family. Just like the river wants to get the dust from the feet of Krishna, we also want charan seva of Krishna. Yatte sujata charanam buruham sthaneshu bhita shanai priya dadi mahi karkasheshu. We also want the dust from the feet of Krishna. But to get that, our parents, father's side and father-in-law's side, they're holding our hands. So we are almost like a river and we are not able to move. But how is it? Just like the waves of the river at that time tremble because they are fighting with the banks. Dear devotees, the word bhuja, which means waves for a river, they also mean arms for the gopis. So the gopis are saying, using the word bhuja, they are playing a double meaning in this word, by saying, just like when the banks hold the river, the waves tremble. Similarly, when the two families hold us, our arms tremble, that let me go, please let me go, please don't do this to me, please let me go. But we are not allowed, we are not able to. Also, another thing that they mention here, which is very interesting, is kula in Sanskrit means family. But the word kula also means banks. So the gopis are saying, just like the river is stuck between two kulas, we are also, which means two banks, we are also stuck between two families. This is another beautiful interpretation. Then the gopis are saying, so basically the gopis are saying eight things, eight similarities between the river and their life. First, the river is not able to see Krishna because Krishna is in a distance. What to speak of not seeing Krishna? They desire to touch the feet and take the dust. That also they don't get. Similarly, oh gopis, oh Ali, oh Sakhi, this is our life. We desire to see Krishna and take the dust from his lotus feet. That is not available for us. Second, we have domestic obstruction. Domestic obstruction. And our husband desires that we go towards him. Just like the ocean desires the river goes towards them. But the river, which is going towards the ocean, bhagnagati, and desires to go towards Krishna when Krishna calls. Similarly, our situation is like that. We desire not to go to the ocean, but to break the flow of our services and run to Krishna. Point number three, the two banks of the ocean represent the two families' boundaries that we are stuck into. Point number four, bhuja means waves are trembling for the river. But bhuja also means arms for us that are trembling when we are stopped. Also, kula means family for us. But kula also means banks in Sanskrit. So the river is stopped between two kulas and we are stopped between two families. Not just by the husband, but the father's side, father-in-law's side, and our situation is like the river. Sixth point, when the waves are trembling, when the waves are trembling, all that they can do is tremble. But when after a certain point, they try too much, they fall in intoxicated mood of separation, and therefore sthambita avastha. So Yamuna also freezes like that. Yamuna either freezes in happiness, in stunned ecstasy, or in helplessness. So our life is also like that, dear Sakhi. We either are stunned in ecstasy for being accepted, or we freeze in helplessness. Sixth point, we desire to go to Krishna, but our ocean does not desire to come to Krishna. Our husband, the river, so I'm speaking from the side of the river. The river desires, being a female, desires to go to Krishna, but the ocean does never comes to Krishna. Similarly, our life is also like that. Our husband also, ocean also, the gopis say, never come. And also similarities, the river is female, we are female, and the cows have a feminine name. So when Krishna calls out to the cows, I feel he's calling out to me, dear Sakhi. And the river is also like this. But the gopis are saying here, the similarity here between the river and us is very, very beautiful phrase. They say that, Iva a bahu punyaha. Punya means spiritual credit. Bahu means too much spiritual credit. And Iva means as if. A bahu punyaha. A means without, bahu means too much, and punya means spiritual credit. So only those who have bahu punya, very fortunate, they get to be with Krishna. But we are a bahu punya. We don't get to be with Krishna. And dear Sakhi, the life of the river is also like that. It is also a bahu punya. It does not have enough punya to break family ties and go to Krishna. So dear devotees, look at this very beautiful point. Sarva bhuteshu yaha pashyet bhagavan bhavamatmanah bhutani bhagavatyatmani eshah bhagavatottama. Bhagavatam describes what is the qualification of a pure Vaishnav. He sees Krishna in all circumstances. So there are two meanings to that. One, a pure Vaishnav sees everyone taking shelter of Krishna in their own individual bhav. Someone takes shelter of Ramchandra, someone takes shelter of Narasingha, someone takes shelter of Varahadev, someone takes shelter of Rukmini Dwarkadish in their own bhav. Or even higher is to see everyone taking shelter of Krishna in our bhav. So gopis here are not seeing the river taking shelter of Krishna in the river's bhav. The gopis are able to see Krishna in this circumstance by seeing the river taking shelter of Krishna in their own bhav. So how beautiful is this? As grihasthas, as worldly men in this world, the lesson that we can learn practically is whatever happens around, we can connect that and learn lessons out of it. The river may or may not have this bhav, but look how the gopis are expressing their heart in this mood. Of course, in Vrindavan they do, but I'm saying in general, if you see around, it is not. But the gopis here are seeing their gopi bhav even in rivers, even in trees, even in deer, and even in cows. So this whole chapter of very beautiful couplets, very beautiful pairs, goes in different stories. They mention about the trees, they mention about the cows, they mention about the river, they mention about the demigods. So with more time in the future, we can go to another pair and discuss their pangs of separation. But here, very specifically, the topic is verse 1, Krishna's description, taking the cows there, and verse 2, the effect that happens because of this cause. Keeping interest of time, I offer my obeisances to all the wonderful Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis who have assembled here. Thank you so much for your lovely participation. Please forgive me for going about 4 minutes over time. Please forgive me for the mistakes that I may have made in this presentation. To err is human, to forgive is divine. So all of you, please forgive me. Repeatedly falling at your lotus feet, repeatedly each one of you, I am offering my obeisances to each one of you. Please kindly accept my personal obeisances at your feet. And please don't forget to offer your blessings, prayers, best wishes. Because only the prayers of Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis protect us. Our sadhana, our seva, we may get proud out of all of these services. Very precarious situation. But it is all useless. Two fingers. The little finger is our sadhana. But the bigger one is the Kripa. So today is Ekadashi Tithi, and we are on the verge of starting our Purushottam Adhik Mas Vrat. So I beg all the devotees on this day of Ekadashi, if not 1 minute, at least 30 seconds after the discussion, at your own homes, at your own time, please close your eyes and remember me and pray for me. May Krishna protect me. When so many Vaishnavas pray, Krishna as Paramatma will help me. if I'm taking some wrong turn in life, in my sadhana or in my seva or in my relations in this world, if I'm taking some wrong turn in my decision making, Krishna as Paramatma will steer and bring me to the, will navigate my, the vehicle of my spiritual journey on the right track. Not because I deserve it or desire it, but when so many Vaishnavas pray, it cannot go in vain. Krishna is bound by the affection and the ropes of devotion. So dear devotees, this is the only begging alms that I came to ask for. I cannot ask, as soon as I come, I cannot say, please pray for me. I must do something so that you feel pity and you will pray for me. So this is the only thing I beg you. Please sincerely pray for me. Hare Krishna.
Jai. Thank you very much, Prabhu. Thank you so much for your wonderful class. In fact, we have so much time for you, Prabhu. You are not even over time today. 4 minutes is not a big thing for us. So, Prabhu, there are some few questions. I'm not sure what is your schedule looks like.
Just like you have all the time for me, I have all my life for you. Please.
Yeah. So, Rukmini Mataji, please go ahead. We can't hear you, Mataji.
Oh, I'm not able to hear.
You're not hearing?
It's now a little feeble.
I'm getting closer. Can you hear now?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much for taking us to Braj and to the Gopis. And it was a wonderful vision and very blessed to hear these pastimes. So I have one question about one thing that you said. It's a question I've been wondering about. So you mentioned the humkrita of the cows, that they make this sound, and it's the dhenu bij hum, and that, you know, just if the cow just says that, then, you know, Krishna is immediately drawn to the cow. And what's interesting is that this same bij is also the krodh bij that the brahmanas used to kill King Vena. And when I found this a few months ago, I was quite startled. I was like, how can these two be the same bij? So do you have any thoughts on that?
Yadrishi bhavana yasya siddhir bhavati tadrishi. The same thing can be used depending on our intention.
Mm-hmm.
There are brahmanas who use mantras to bless, and the same mantras they use to curse also.
Mm-hmm.
So it is the bhavana. The cow here is doing hum to get Krishna, and there they are doing hum to curse. So just like in Sanskrit, there are so many words which mean opposite things, actually. So many things. The word da, for example, which we say, bhuvi grinanti ye bhurida janaha, right? So the word bhuridaha there means, da means dadati, and bhuri means prachuramatra, in great abundance. So bhurida means a magnanimous donor, bhurida janaha. But Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur comments, from the Vamya Bhav and Dakshina Bhav, if you see, it's an exact opposite. There, bhuri means profuse, and da means a killer. So the gopis who are from Chandravali's camp saying, oh, we are so blessed that we heard from some Harikatha speaker the glories of Krishna. They are magnanimous donors giving us Krishna, that today we are, feeling the pangs of separation. From Radharani's camp, they are saying, who was that person who came and spoke to us about Krishna? Bhurida, he has killed us completely. He has destroyed us. So it's beautiful, that whole verse, Tava Kathamritam. In fact, all the verses of the Gopi Gita, it's the same verse, but they move in two different meanings depending on the bhav. Like, for example, I'm feeling very greedy to go one step more. Please forgive me. So Tava Kathamritam Tapta Jeevanam. Yeah. So Tava Kathamritam. So from Chandravali's camp, the Sakhi is saying, Tava Katha, Krishna, your Katha is Amrit, is nectarian. For whom? Tapta Jeevanam. We are in pain without you, but when we hear your flute sound, it is Amrit. Our life is Tapta Jeevanam, but when we hear your flute sound, we become soothed, it's Amritam. But Radharani's camp is saying, Krishna, Tava Katha Mritam. Krishna, your words kill us. And if we don't die, it makes us tapta jivanam. helpless. Therefore, Chandravali's camp is saying, Bhuvi grinanti ye bhurida janaha. Who was that magnanimous donor who came and spoke Krishna Katha to us first? And Radharani is also asking the same thing. Who is that person who first came and spoke about Krishna to us? Da means to give, but da also means to kill. So he has profusely destroyed our family life. He has destroyed everything. He took away everything from us and we came to give ourselves to him. And now he rejected us also. So who is that person who first spoke to us about Krishna? So in this way, yadrishi bhavana yasya siddhir bhavati tadrishi. Depending on our bhav, directions are decided.
Very beautiful. Thank you so much,
Guru. Thank you, Guru. The next question is from Padma Lochani Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Dhanvat Pranam. A very beautiful class. So, Prabhuji, I have a question because you were mentioning about Lalita Sakhi. She is 27 days elder. And then we also know Vishakha Sakhi. She is the same day as Radharani, same time. And some gopis are younger. So how do we understand the time aspect in Goloka Vrindavan, Prabhuji?
So basically, Goloka Vrindavan has no time span, right? When we say time for us, it controls us and it makes us age. But in Goloka Vrindavan, time is according to Krishna's desire. So Krishna desires six seasons at the same time. They all come at the same time. But it's still interesting that Radharani is counted as 14 years, 2 months and 15 days. And Krishna is counted as 15 years, 9 months, etc. Lalita Sakhi also, you know, 27 days old, or Vishakha Sakhi on the same day. So what it actually means is when you look at their beautiful forms in Goloka Vrindavan, when they appear in this world, when Radharani appeared in this world and how she looked on the 15th day of the second month of the 14th year, that's how she looks there. So in her Bhauma Leelas, when Radharani appears and she is performing the pastime of growing up, on her 14th year, in the second month and the 15th day, the way she looks is how exactly she looks in Goloka Vrindavan. So to say that that is her age there doesn't mean that she's gone through 14 years in Goloka Vrindavan, but it is, the form is like that you see in the Prakat Leelas. Like that. Very special.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Yeah, I just wanted to understand that, you know.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Who is that little Sakha or Sakhi?
Tulsi, Prabhuji.
Tulsi. Ah, Lali. Yes.
When I clock, I like that Krishna came in the form of bumblebee to touch Radharani's lotus flower feet.
Yes. You like that?
I like that. I like that, and I also like that the fruit fell down, and the peacock feather was falling Radharani's feet.
Oh, you are very
that
rasic.
Is like funny class.
Very rustic. So you like so from the whole section, you like those sections where Krishna was becoming adhin to Radharani. Being conquered by Radharani. Very good. This is Gaudiya mood. One of Radharani's nature is Swadhina Bhartrika Bhav, which means she completely controls Krishna. That Akhila Brahmanda Nayaka becomes Smaragarala Khandanam Mama Shirasi Mandanam Dehi Padapallavam Udaram Shri Radhe Dehi Padapallavam Udaram. That, O Radharani, please decorate my head with the lotus feet of yours. This is the mood of Gaudiya Vaishnavism. Therefore, in Vrindavan, we don't have kingdom. We have queendom. We don't have king. The king of Dwarka becomes the servant of the queen of Braj. This is our Sambandha Gyan. So very nice.
Prabhuji, I like Nana Srimatradhika is the Ladini Shakti of Krishna. And you also give me your blessing that can I be the big devotee of Krishna.
You want to become big devotee of Krishna. May Radha and Krishna eternally protect you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol.
The next question is from Amar Jyoti Prabhu.
Hare Bol, Prabhu. Prabhu, we heard that Krishna came to Nandagaon from Gokul because Kamsa was attacking again and again. But is there any reason to come Radharani from Rawal to Barsana?
Well, Nanda Maharaj and Vrishabhanu Maharaj are best of friends. And when Nanda Maharaj moved, it was not an overnight movement. The movement took a long, long time. It's described, it took many, many months. In fact, some years even, because they have to move from bullock cart after bullock cart, move into small villages, and then gradual movement. So Vrishabhanu Maharaj also, he moved with Nanda Baba. And they came very close to each other, Nandagram and Barsana. Previously, of course, Raval and Gokul, they had come close to the Yamuna, because both wanted a child. Vrishabhanu Maharaj wanted a child, and Nanda Baba also wanted a child. So by doing Vrat near Yamuna, all the desires get fulfilled. So then Krishna, Nanda Baba got Nanda Nandan, and Vrishabhanu Maharaj got Vrishabhanu Nandini. So then when they moved, they decided, yes, we will also move.
And the second question, Prabhuji, that we heard that Sridhama cursed Krishna and Radharani from 100 years separation. Is it correct, Prabhu? We heard from some Sri Krishna serial. I don't know if it's correct or not.
My request to you would be in general, this is just a general thing, that always with scriptural proof, things must be accepted. Because sometimes in the television, whether it's Mahabharata serial or Ramayana or Sri Krishna, there'll be some discrepancy, there'll be some addition, some masala for TRP. So, you know, I'm just saying in general, anytime anything is shown, we must see for Praman. Now, as far as the curse is concerned, as far as cursing Radha and Krishna is concerned, I am not sure. There is a story of the curse that Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj mentions in his Radharani book. But I have not heard of the curse of both Radha and Krishna. If there is a Praman, we can always accept.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
So, thank you, Prabhu. I didn't see any other questions. If nobody else has, I have a question, Prabhu.
Okay, please go ahead.
So, my question is, Radharani is in Virag Bhav almost most of the time in Vrindavan, after Krishna left Vrindavan. Is it the same thing? It happens in Goloka Vrindavan also? Always will be Radharani will be in anxiety of Krishna being in separation, or they all will be like together?
Very beautiful. In Goloka Vrindavan, there is Samyog and Vipralamba. But the interesting thing is, the Vipralamba happens as far as leaving Radharani, but still in Braj. See, Krishna never leaves Vrindavan in Goloka Vrindavan. Mm-hmm. No. In Krishna Leela, there is Goloka, Golok Leela, there is Mathura Leela, Dwarka Leela. And in Mathura Leela, Mathura Aye Dina Dayardhar Natha Hai Mathura Nath. Mathura Nath is always in Mathura, in Nitya Mathura. Dwarkadish is always in Dwarkadish. And in Goloka Vrindavan, Krishna is always in Vrindavan. Srila Prabhupada's godbrother, Srila Bhaktivedanta Vaman Maharaj, was once mentioning that in his Bengali class transcription, that in Goloka Vrindavan, Nitya Golok, Nitya Mathura, Nitya Dwarka, Krishna is always present where he is. There's no movement of Krishna. But that movement takes place in the Bhauma Leelas, because there individual Krishnas are present. But here one Krishna does Gaman and Agaman. He moves from Vrindavan to Mathura, and that same moves from Mathura to Dwarka. But when he's moving from Vrindavan to Mathura, he's not in Vrindavan and Dwarka. And when he's moving from Mathura to Dwarka, he's not in Vrindavan and Mathura. But there, he's simultaneously present. So in Goloka Vrindavan, Krishna never leaves Goloka Vrindavan and goes somewhere else. He's always in Vrindavan. Still, Radharani has viraha because he leaves her to do other things also. There is Ashtakalya Leela, eightfold pastimes. In that, from 10:48 in the morning to 3:36 in the afternoon, Krishna meets Radharani at Radhakund. But at the same time, at 10:48 at night to 3:36 in the morning, they again meet. It's called Nishanta Leela. So only these two faces, there is direct meeting. But other times, you see Krishna is moving. He does Gocharan. He's with Nanda and Yashoda. He's Gopas, Gopis, etc., etc. So there is separation, meaning Krishna has left me. But the separation that Krishna has left Braj doesn't exist. But it is so beautiful. I just want to add one more point here. That when that viraha takes place, this is called as Bhavi Viraha. Bhavi Viraha means where there is viraha in the mind, in the bhav. So Radharani is feeling, oh, today he has left me. Tomorrow he will leave all of us. And maybe just because this is a village, he may leave this village and go to a city. And he may just settle down in a city, forgetting all of us. This doesn't happen in Golok Vrindavan. It's just the thought process of Radharani that this may happen. And Krishna is so kind that to show the deep attachment Radharani has for Krishna, when he comes in this world, he displays the fears of Radharani in her heart by practically exemplifying those leelas. So when Krishna leaves Vrindavan in this Prakat Leela and goes to Mathura and settles down there and forgets the Brajbasis, it's not that he has done it in Golok, but that happens in the bhava of Radharani, that I hope that doesn't happen. So that bhavi viraha in the heart of Radharani is never seen by anyone. But Krishna is so kind to take that thought of Radharani and display it to the whole mankind. So therefore, when a Brajrasik Vaishnav reads 10th canto Bhagavatam, when Krishna leaves Vrindavan and performs pastimes in Mathura and Dwarka, he will see that the Vrindavan Leelas are only 40 chapters and outside Vrindavan 50 chapters. So he does not think that, oh, that is outside Vrindavan, this is inside Vrindavan. He feels so grateful. Whatever has happened in the 50 chapters outside Vrindavan is what happens in the heart of Radharani in Golok. That maybe demons will come and attack Krishna. Maybe he will get married to 16,000 queens. Who knows? Today he has left me. Maybe he will. So all he never leaves in Golok Vrindavan. He comes back to Radharani when the time is right. But that bhavi viraha of Radharani is exemplified in this world in Prakat Leela.
Thank you, Prabhu. So Kalindi Mataji has a question.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Amarendra Prabhu, please accept our humble obeisances. I'm so sorry, you know, I know today you're giving class, but there is Arudha Mataji class also about homeschool. I have to attend as a mother that I miss half of her class, you know, but hopefully it's on YouTube or somewhere I can get it. So Prabhu, I have a question. You will fix it, okay? Because I'm a mother with two kids, you understand. If I'm wrong somewhere, you will fix it. So that is, one is, okay, let me see. So I hear that all the, when we talk about Radharani, yeah, Radharani is most merciful, very merciful, okay? So like one goat when in Vrindavan, he in the cave, and when Radharani hear the sound, he take out the goat.
Fox, yeah.
So, and that is Radharani, with Radharani shelter, we'll get easy to Krishna. And that is also I hear from devotee, like, look, take shelter of Gornitai, and that way we can go to Radha Krishna. Huh? Because, and as a Grihastha, best to Navadvip, then Vrindavan. Vrindavan is good for Brahmachari and Sannyas. So which one we take? Which one, like, that all correct? All different way talking, everywhere is kind. So which one I take, like, as a Grihastha, which one is more important, which is go more through with my life, our life? Like,
Sheshambandha nahi jar, britho janma gelo tar, sei poshu bodo durachar. Nitayro koruna hobe, broje radha krishna pabe. Heno nitay bine bhai radha krishna paite nai. All of this, Drudha Dhari Nitayera Charan. Narottam Das Thakur says that, hold on to Nitai Chaitanya. They will give Radha Krishna, no problem. Krishna Naam Kori Aparadera Vichar. Krishna Naam does Aparadera Vichar. But Chaitanya Nitananda Nahi Eshava Vichar. Naam Le Prem De Bahe Ashrudhar. Nahi Eshava Vichar. Gaur naam, Gaur dham, Gaur roop gun, aparada nahi mani tarite nipun. So in this way, all these pramans are there that we should worship Chaitanya Nityananda. There is no doubt about it. But naturally, the fruit that Chaitanya Nityananda will give in our heart by worshiping them nicely is Radha Krishna Preeti. Is love for Radha Krishna automatically. And this has been mentioned by Prabodhananda Saraswati. Yatha yatha gaurapadara vinde, bindeta bhaktim krita punya rashi. Just like the moon increases in size, the attraction of the moon pulls the waves in the ocean. Less waves will be there, but by the when the moon gets fuller and fuller, the attraction pulls and there are bigger waves. So Prabodhanand Saraswati says that moon is Chaitanya Chandra. And this ocean is Radha Rani. So the waves of Radha Kripa will automatically come when the moon gets fuller and fuller and fuller. That is Gaur Bhakti continues. So Aradhitam Navavanam Vrajakananaste. If we worship nine islands of Navadvip, we worship 12 forests of Braja. Naradhitam Navavanam Vrajaeva Dure. But if you don't worship Navadvip, you don't get Radha Braja. And Aradhita Dvijasuto Vrajanagaraste. If you worship Jagannath Mishra's son, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then you're worshipping Krishna. Naradhita Dvijasuto Nataveha Krishna. But if you don't worship Chaitanya Chandra, then Krishna Bhakti is not complete. So therefore, as Grihasthas, the practical start is Chaitanya Nityananda. And then Chaitanya Nityananda, and then it becomes Chaitanya Gaur Gadadhar. And they automatically lead to Radha Krishna. Automatic, no problem. Mm-hmm. So we can worship Gaur Nithai.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol. Hey, Chotu. Apna ke kono prashna ache?
Hare Krishna, Narendra. I have a question.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, so initially he started with the saying that I didn't know where to start. So this phenomenon of Radha Krishna and Vipralamba, Radha and his mood is only somehow given to this world by Gaudiya Sampradaya. It's not there much in Sri Sampradaya, Madhu Sampradaya, any other Sampradaya. So even Christianity, Islam, Judaism, if you name it, anything, there are many ways to love God, not to God. But this bhava was only preserved, kept as a secret. And then from Ishwar, started giving to that, come and open this place to the world. So how do we understand the people who are in the different path? Because in the picture, we understand, like a lot of people are different persons. How do we meet them or communicate to them? This is even though it's there, but it's not there. Would you like to add? I don't know how they made this question.
When we see monkeys in Vrindavan, intelligence lies in hiding the pearl necklace, not in showing it. So, Vipralamba, Radha Krishna Vipralamba is a pearl necklace. And people in general are monkeys. So this is never given out. But Sriman Mahaprabhu is so kind. He takes that pearl necklace and puts it around the neck of a monkey. That is all of us. This is his kripa. So generally it never comes out. This Vipralamba Bhava comes only once in the day of Brahma. Anarpita charim chirat karuna yavatirna hakalo. Only once. Hey Radhe, Braja Devi Kecha. Kutaha, hey Randa Suna, Kutaha. This crying and weeping can come only from the heart of someone who experiences it. Most of the path don't even talk about love. What to speak of loving separation?
Yeah.
They speak about dhanam dehi, vittam dehi, grihini dehi, griham dehi. Give me house. Grihini griham uchyate. Give me a house, but give me a wife also in that house. So we go to God to fulfill our needs. This is the most general understanding. But niswartha seva is a very high class thing in itself. And that too to Lakshmi Narayan. Now what to speak of Rukmini Dwarakadish? And then what to speak of Krishna in Vrindavan, and then what to speak of Radha and Krishna in the Nikunjas of Vrindavan, in selfless mood, and that too now in separation. This is like inconceivable, Prabhu. Inconceivable. In the hierarchy of consciousness, this is inconceivable. So only as much as Parikshit can digest as a child, only that much Vraj Bhakti Mataji will give him. If Parikshit can digest only Seralak, Mataji will give only Seralak. Although he may ask for aloo paratha or something, but she will not give, right? But as his digestion capacity increases, the mother knows and the mother will give. So nobody can digest this prema, including Krishna cannot. Therefore, he came down as Chaitanya. He could not digest. He couldn't see this. So therefore, he said, I cannot understand this.
Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Ki Drishova Nayiva Swadhyo Yenad Bhuta Madhurima Ki Drishova Madhya Saukyam Chasya Mad Anubhavataha Ki Drishoveti Lobad Tad Bhavadhya Samajani Shachi Garbhasindho Harindhu. Krishna could not digest this Vipralambha. He couldn't understand. Could not understand. Therefore, he took the heart of Radha. And when he took the heart of Radha, Rani, you see, this bottle is not overflowing now because there's not much water inside. If I keep pouring it more and more and more and more and more and more, it comes out. Why? Because it is so full that it has no more capacity to hold. When Krishna took the heart of Radharani, he actually came only to drink that nectar. But it was so much quantity and quality that he had no capacity to hold it. So whatever was excess came out. And therefore he gave it to us. So it's a rare phenomenon. God never gives it. In fact, God does not understand it himself, what to speak of giving it. But here, we are very, very blessed to be in the Rupanuga Gaudiya Guru Parampara. It is a great... We respect all paramparas, but we have a great abhiman about the line that we come from. Great abhiman. Great abhiman. We come in the line of the likes of Prabodhananda Saraswati and Rupa and Raghunath Das Goswami. Lifetime after lifetime, we will not move anywhere. Even if we don't get success in our line, we will still not move anywhere. Very rare. So we have been blessed. What can we do? Logic is not working here.
That's what, why am I here? I'm in the wrong place, but I'm still here.
We should taste this. Rupa Raghunatha Pade Chahara As Chaitanya Charitamrita Kahe Krishna Das. All the time begging at the feet of Rupa and Raghunath Das Goswami. If not Rupa Goswami, actually Mahaprabhu gave it, yes. He was experiencing and he was erupting. And Nityananda Prabhu gave it. But Nitai gave it exclusively to that generation. Who's going to give it to me? I don't see Nitai and Haridas knocking at my door to give it to me. Who's going to give it to me? It was Rupa Goswami who wrote all of this and analyzed. You see, someone may see a gymnastic performance, a girl is jumping around and flipping somersaults. Someone will say, that's it, huh? Very simple, I can also do it. We will end up breaking our hip or breaking our back. So someone may think, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu rolling on the floor, jumping, falling like a bag of bones, tears out. This is only bhakti. Very simple, I can also do this. Jump, roll, dance, laugh, aha. I am also facing Madanakya Mahabhava. But it was Rupa Goswami who explained the science behind those ecstatic symptoms and said, it is a long process, Baba. You cannot imitate these things. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says, a lady who's going to give birth to a child, she may scream with labor pain. But the lady in the neighboring bed will also scream, but she may not be pregnant. You know, she may scream, but she's not going to get a baby because she doesn't have it. So by screaming, you're not going to get a baby. But someone who has a baby may scream. So Mahaprabhu who has love may erupt in ecstasy. But by showing those ecstasies, not necessary you have that love. Rupa Goswami established this. This is why we have Abhiman, Prabhu. We have Abhiman. This is a good Abhiman to have.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. All glories to Srila Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna. I am seeing the divine couple on the screen.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. I just wanted to express my gratitude for accepting our invitation and giving your association today. Very, very beautiful, excellent class, Prabhu. Thank you so much. I just want to express. Hare Krishna.
I want to thank you for very lovingly facilitating and contacting me and inviting me. Thank you for being a very wonderful bridge between the ISKCON Columbus management and contacting me. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Prabhuji, there is one question in YouTube from Ajay Nithai Prabhu, and he was asking the reference of the sloka, Gaurim Raktavaram Ramyam Sunetram
Sushmitananam Shama Swabhishta Sadika Radhika Ashraya Sada. This comes from the Stavavali of Raghunath Das Goswami.
Okay. So I think the questions are done, Prabhu. There is one request from Mataji, and the kid wants to recite a sloka. If you have some time.
Please, go ahead.
Sheetal Mataji, please go ahead.
Hare Krishna, I am Nitya.
I want to say one shloka.
Please go ahead.
Krishnaya Vasudevaya Hare Brahmatmane Pranat Kleshnashaya Govindaya Namo Namah.
Very sweet. Very sweet. How old are you?
6.
6 years old. Very nice. Very good. I really pray to Bhanu Nandini Shri Krishna that you keep memorizing more and more verses. And as you all get older, you understand the meaning and you share it with others also. I'm very happy to hear. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna Prabhu. There are two more questions came up in the YouTube. Is that okay?
Okay.
So one is the difference between gopis, manjaris, and shakis and their moods. So what is the difference?
That is a seminar. That's not a question. That's a seminar. That's a seminar from Ujjwal Neelamani. So, I can't even say this in short.
Okay.
It's difficult.
So there is another question if you want to pass it. So how can we overcome fear? Please answer, Prabhu.
Bhajahure mana Shri Nandanandana Abhaya Charanaravindare Durlabha Manava Janama Satsange Tarahue Bhavasindure. Govinda Das has given the direct answer. Abhaya Charanaravindare Bhajahure mana. Oh, mind, give your mind to Krishna. Shri Nanda Nandana Abhaya Charanaravindare. Do bhajan and automatically good qualities will come. Abhayam Sattva Samshuddhim Jnana Yoga Vyavastitihi Danam Damascha Yajnascha Swadhyaya Stapa Arjavam Ahimsa Satyam Akrodha Tyaga Shantira Paishunam Daya Bhuteshva Loluktvam Mardhavam Hirachapalam. Krishna has said divine and demoniac qualities in the Bhagavad Gita. He starts off with Abhayam. So we will get Abhaya by performing bhakti, by following the instructions of Abhaya Charanaravinda Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you so much for your patience and explaining and giving all the explanations, whatever we asked for. And we dragged you so long. And thank you so much. And Ram Tirtha Prabhu or Naveen Prabhu, if you have anything in the last comments.
Oh, thank you, Amarendra Prabhu. Thank you very much. And we should plan as soon as... Because of course, rain check is there. Somehow we put it in a back burner this year, supposed to. And our next schedule allows, please put us back in the calendar.
Absolutely, it'll be my pleasure to come and sit with all of you and do nice kirtan with Hari and Narahari and Parikshit and all the wonderful Radha Natavar Kirtankar Sangha to do nice bhajans and kirtans and nice discussions with all of you. I really hope and wish and pray this whole pandemic situation settles down personally and collectively for everyone. And I really beg all of you, please pray for me. Really pray for me. I don't want anything else from all of you. Please pray for me. Let us sincerely, please promise to give me that arm. And I promise you, as soon as the situation, the travel restrictions are all taken off, if my health is okay, I will be very happy to come.
Thank you.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Dandavat Pranam.
Dandavat Pranam.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Bol. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Dandavat Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. Radhe Radhe Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. Jai Shri Radhe. Hare
Krishna, Prabhuji. All glory to Srila Prabhupada Maharaj.
All glories to Srila Prabhupada Maharaj.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol. Hare Krishna.
Thank you for the class, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Hare Bol.
Hare Krishna.
Itai Gaur Premanande.
Hare Hare.
Hare Bol.
Thank you all for joining us today.
Amarendra Prabhu ki.
Yeah.
He left.
Devotees. We have some announcements, few announcements. Alek Prabhu will take over from here. So, Prabhu, please go ahead.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Can you see me? Can you hear me?
Yes.
You can see the slides, right? Okay, so thank you so much, devotees, everyone who joined on the Zoom call as well as on the YouTube. We had over 130 participants, so really grateful to all of you for giving your time, precious time, to hear the Harikatha from His Grace Amarendra Prabhu. So, you know, we are already over time. I'll quickly go through the announcements for today. This week's festivals, we have Purushottam Mass, the month of Purushottam, coming, starting from the Thursday, September 17th, also known as the month of Radha Krishna Yugal. And there are numerous benefits, and the couple I have mentioned here, that all the holy places in the world come to reside in our body, and one who observes Purushottam month with faith and devotion will go back home, back to Godhead, to serve Radha Govinda eternally in Golok Vrindavan. So, there are more things that are there to be followed during Purushottam month. So really great time to improve, you know, chanting. If you're not chanting, you can starting this month, the most spiritual month of the year. And, you know, more charity should be done. Brahmana should be offered food and more devotional service. So, you know, please do that. And today is Ekadashi. So like always, so we have 3-hour Kirtan, Ekadashi Kirtan, starting today at 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. Eastern time. The Kirtan will be broadcasted on our Facebook group, Columbus Sankirtan Party, as well as on our YouTube channel, ISKCON Columbus. So if you are not subscribed, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, ISKCON Columbus. And like you can see that, you know, all our talks are live streamed there. Harinam, everything is uploaded on YouTube. So if you miss out anything, you can just go back and watch it again. And our next Shravanam Saturday speaker will be announced soon through emails or WhatsApp group. Then our next Sunday's feast speaker is His Grace Braj Mohan Prabhu. He's a lifestyle coach and resident monk at ISKCON Chowpatty since 2006. And he has a lot of online courses, and he spreads the message of Lord Chaitanya and Srila Prabhupada throughout the world. He travels a lot, and we are very fortunate to have him give his association to us virtually next Sunday. So please join our Zoom call or subscribe to YouTube channel so you can follow that lecture as well. The topic will be shared in our newsletters. So thank you all so much. We know, you know, everyone is absorbed in a lot of services, and your services may not be visible to all, but know that, you know, it's appreciated. And any other announcements, anyone?
Just one thing, bro. I think is Holiness Bhakti Charu Swami's Vyas Puja is there in the festival says this week, coming week. Yeah.
17th. The weekend?
Yeah, actually on 17th Wednesday, there is a prasadam give out at the temple and at Prem Sindhu Prabhu's house. So those who want to do an RSVP, please contact Prem Sindhu Prabhu or Leela Manji Mataji, or any of us here, so we can know how to cook, how much amount, quantity to be cooked for it. And it can be picked up in the evening between 5 to 6. Yeah.
So, Prabhu, it's 17th Thursday, right, Prabhu?
Yeah.
I think it's Wednesday. Thursday. Okay. Yeah, Thursday.
Hare Krishna, Prabhus.
Yes, Mataji.
On 8th, it was Alec Prabhu's birthday.
Hare Krishna.
Please, all the Vaishnavas of Columbus, and I said, please give blessings to this wonderful soul who is our techie here. Because of his wonderful and dedicated service, we're having all these live, YouTube live, and everything.
Many, many happy live. Krishna conscious birthday, Prabhu. So, belated happy birthday wishes.
Belated happy birthday, Prabhu.
Even though you kept it secret, Alec Prabhu, I got it.
Happy birthday. And then Hare Krishna, happy birthday.
Thank you, all the devotees. Please,
happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Many happy returns of the day, Alek Prabhu.
Thank you so much,
Sita. Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Happy birthday. Happy Krishna consciousness birthday.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Please pray for me. Please bless so that we continue to serve you all. We continue to serve Shri Shri Radha Narbar and
may all the previous acharyas and the mercy.
Happy birthday, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Okay. Thank you for your wonderful services, Prabhuji.
Thank you very much, Prabhu.
All your mercy, you are giving the opportunity. Nothing else.
Happy birthday, Alek Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Prabhu.
Alek Prabhu, you're my hero.
You are.
Nice to meet you.